Yeah, what's up? This is Aunt Moazal right here, back again with another episode of my show. Now on today's topic, I want to do a real quick video about Phil Jackson. Now it's a video that I did about a week ago. It's called Chris Broussard Dropping Heavy Knowledge on Undisputed. In that video, I went in a little bit about Phil Jackson, but I want to go in again about him again because I only talked about like a little bit of it. I let the Chris Broussard clip play for y'all. But now I want to, you know, add my two cents to this topic because this white man, Phil Jackson, he's an NBA basketball coach. Y'all probably remember him. He coached Michael Jordan and Scottie Pippen in the Chicago Bulls dynasty. He also coached Kobe Bryant and Shaq, the Lakers dynasty, when they won three championships. And he coached Kobe and Pau Gasol and Lamar Odom and them, you know, a couple years ago to championships. So he's a well-known NBA basketball coach. Now, the reason he got all of his championship rings is because somehow he always ends up coaching the greatest players in the league. You understand? So, of course, he's going to be a great coach. If you got Michael Jordan on your team, you got Shaq and Kobe and all these legends. But anyway, right now, Phil Jackson is he's the general manager, team president for the New York Knicks. He's like the guy in the front office. But he been in the news lately for saying a lot of slick shit. You know what I'm saying? He said some slick shit about LeBron. He also said some slick shit about Carmelo the other day. You know what I'm saying? And like I say, he coming across like not necessarily on some critical shit, but he just like coming across on some arrogant white supremacist type shit. You feel me? The way he be talking, because like I was saying, if y'all go back and look at the video Chris Broussard dropping Heavy Knowledge on Undisputed, y'all will see that this dude taking shots at LeBron James. Not just like shots, like not like being critical of him as a basketball player, but he talking about dudes and posses and, you know, saying like not necessarily racist shit, but just, you know, offensive shit, you know, disrespectful shit. You understand what I'm saying? So then when he made the comment on what he said about LeBron, he ain't really apologize about it. Like I said, y'all gotta look it up. Just look up the LeBron James and Phil Jackson situation. I forgot exactly what he said, but when he made a comment on about what he said, he didn't apologize for it. He just made some bullshit statement, basically saying like, oh, I wasn't really wrong. I just was wrong about talking about another team's player. I wasn't wrong about what I said, the disrespectful shit about LeBron. So the other night he said some shit about Carmelo too, because you remember Carmelo defended LeBron against Phil Jackson with the posse comments. So now he took a shot at Carmelo and shit, talking about Carmelo holding the ball too long. And like I said, I think that was just some calculated shit that he did. He wasn't really mad about Carmelo holding the ball too long. He probably just wanted to go at Carmelo because Carmelo defended LeBron. Like I said, he's always been known for this shit, taking shots at Kobe and Shaq when they was playing on the team and shit. He wrote a whole book about Kobe and Shaq. Y'all can go look that up, just because y'all remember the year when Shaq got traded from the Lakers. He wrote a book about that because that was the last year that he coached the Lakers. So yeah, man, he always known for saying little slick shit about black athletes when these superstars is the reason why he's a damn 11-time NBA coach and champion. These basketball players that you love to talk shit about are the reason why you famous and rich and you can get your, you know, million-dollar contracts. This cracker got a fucking $60 million contract just to be a team president. He don't even play. You feel me? Like, that job is like a $1 million contract. But this cracker got a $12 million contract to be a team president because he got that name. He got that cachet. But why? Because of Michael Jordan. Because of Kobe. Because of, you know, legends like Shaq and all these people. But you want to call, you know, disrespect niggas and say niggas got posses and shit. But, you know, we the ones that put you in, you know, position to be in the position you are. You feel me? But like I say, man, it's your man Aunt Moore, so I don't want to go in too hard on this dude. You know, y'all can do the research about the things he be saying, and you can judge for yourself. So just rate, comment, and subscribe. You know me, I'm gonna be back with another episode. One love, holla at me. Me and Shaq, when they was playing on the team and shit, he wrote a whole book about Kobe and Shaq. Y'all can go look that up, just because y'all remember the year when Shaq got traded from the Lakers. He wrote a book about that because that was the last year that he coached the Lakers. So yeah, man, he always known for saying little slick shit about black athletes when these superstars is the reason why he's a damn 11-time NBA coach and champion. These basketball players that you love to talk shit about are the reason why you famous and rich and you can get your, you know, $1 million contracts. This cracker got a fucking $60 million contract just to be a team president. He don't even play. You feel me? Like, that job is like a $1 million contract. But this cracker... Yeah. What's up? This is Ant Moazal right here. Back again with another episode of my show. Now, on today's topic, I want to do a real quick video about Phil Jackson. Now, it's a video that I did about a week ago. It's called Chris Broussard Dropping Heavy Knowledge on Undisputed. And that video, I went in a little bit about Phil Jackson, but I want to go in again about him again because I only talked about like a little bit of it. I let the Chris Broussard clip play for y'all. But now I want to, you know, add my two cents to this topic because this white man, Phil Jackson, he's an NBA basketball coach. Y'all probably remember him. He coached Michael Jordan and Scottie Pippen in the Chicago Bulls dynasty. He also coached Kobe Bryant and Shaq, the Lakers dynasty, when they won. Exactly what he said, but when he made a comment on about what he said, he didn't apologize for it. He just made some bullshit statement, basically saying like, oh, I wasn't really wrong. I just was wrong about talking about another team's player. I wasn't wrong about what I said, the disrespectful shit about LeBron. So the other night, he said some shit about Carmelo, too. Because you remember, Carmelo defended LeBron against Phil Jackson with the posse comments. So now he took a shot at Carmelo and shit, talking about Carmelo holding the ball too long. And like I said, I think that was just some calculated shit that he did. He wasn't really mad about Carmelo holding the ball too long. He probably just wanted to go at Carmelo because Carmelo defended LeBron. Like I said, he's always been known for this shit, taking shots at Kobe 3 championships. And he coached Kobe and Pau Gasol and Lamar Odom and them, you know, a couple years ago to championships. So he's a well-known NBA basketball coach. Now, the reason he got all of his championship rings is because somehow he always ends up coaching the greatest players in the league. You understand? So, of course, he's going to be a great coach. If you got Michael Jordan on your team, you got Shaq and Kobe and all these legends. But anyway, right now, Phil Jackson is he's the general manager, team president for the New York Knicks. He's like the guy in the front office, but he been in the news lately for saying a lot of slick shit. You know what I'm saying? He said some slick shit about LeBron. He also said some slick shit about Carmelo the other day. You know what I'm saying? And like I say, he coming across like not necessarily on some critical shit, but he just like coming across on some arrogant white supremacist type shit. You feel me? The way he be talking, because like I was saying, if y'all go back and look at the video Chris Broussard dropping Heavy Knowledge on Undisputed, y'all will see that this dude taking shots at LeBron James, not just like shots, like not like being critical of him as a basketball player, but he talking about dudes and posses and, you know, saying like not necessarily racist shit, but just, you know, offensive shit, you know, disrespectful shit. You understand what I'm saying? So then when he made the comment on what he said about LeBron, he ain't really apologize about it. Like I said, y'all gotta look it up. Just look up the LeBron James and Phil Jackson situation. I forgot exactly.